Well, with St. Patrick's Day on Monday, many of the celebrations get started tonight. And so police are now upping their patrols to keep us safe on the roads. Allison Montoya is live in Sharonville for us tonight, where you just might see more men and women in uniform this weekend. Hi, Allison.
Hi, good evening to you, Cherie. That's right. You will see a lot more men and women in uniform checking on impaired drivers. We're on US 42 in Sharonville. Take a look here at this checkpoint. Troopers in Hamilton County OVI Task Force officers are both talking to drivers, asking if they had anything to drink tonight and smelling for alcohol. Now, already about half a dozen drivers have been taken to another checkpoint for a sobriety test, but no one has been arrested. So again, this is US 42 north of Interstate 275 at the checkpoint ends at midnight. And according to OSP, last year on St. Patty's Day, they made 142 OVI arrests in the state. Also adding extra officers to combat impaired driving is the city of Fairfield. The department received money from the Ohio Department of Public Safety for their St. Patty's Day blitz, allowing more officers on the road from now until Tuesday morning.
We wanted people to have fun and celebrate and have a good time, but we want them to do it safely. So we'll be out there to make sure that if they're at a party or something like that and they shouldn't be driving when they leave, that we're out there looking for them.
And the checkpoint back here in Sharonville goes until midnight in Warren County. Additional deputies will also be out on the roadways to patrol all weekend long, too. Bottom line here, if you plan on drinking and celebrating St. Patrick's Day holiday, make sure you have a designated driver. Reporting live from Sharonville, Allison Montoya, WLWT News 5.
Now, last year, no one was killed in a traffic crash in Ohio on St. Patrick's Day. That, though, was the first time that occurred in the last 5 years.